still see the remaining high point of ground directly in front of us. And of course, as the warriors came up the gullies and stuff, the commanders wanted control over, especially this high ground. So they would send Company C down from the high ground down into this area, and that's where they would engage the warriors under the command of Lane Whiteman, who was a Cheyenne, just to try to give a better idea of who was where with.
The markers you see at this point on both sides of the road represent soldiers killed as the warriors rushed up from both sides of the ridge. The troopers on Calhoun Hill did a credible job in defending themselves. Look out the left side of the bus, and you will notice that Calhoun Hill isn't just a knob. In 20 minutes, perhaps hoping Benteen and the pack train would arrive. At this time, the rear guard, it was a great anxiety among the burial details, who feared that the warriors might return. Once all bodies were buried, the troops left this area, marching north along the valley of the Little Bighorn, and then the Bighorn River, and back to the safety of the north side of the
July 25th, 1876. At this site, hundreds of Sioux and Cheyenne warriors defeated five cavalry companies, about 220 soldiers, under the command of Lieutenant Colonel George Armstrong Custer. As you look over the battlefield, you can see the white markers showing where the bodies of soldiers were found after the fight. No markers show where the warriors fell, because very little is known of their casualties. Probably less than 100 were killed, and the dead were removed by their families immediately after the battle. Only the Sioux and Cheyenne words tell us what happened to the 200 soldiers killed in the fight. Some Indian accounts say that Custer and his men may have tried to cross the river 1.5 miles to your left. Angry warriors led by Powell raced across the river and forced the troops back to the ridges. Having lost the initiative, the soldiers found themselves in rough terrain, unsuitable for mounted action. The companies seemed to have made individual stands, fighting on foot against the waves of Indians that were rolling in from every direction. The warriors did not need to expose themselves to the troopers' fire. Dismounted, they moved from sagebrush to sagebrush and took advantage of the numerous ravines. Finally, Crazy Horse, crossing farther downstream, below the present visitor center, swept around this ridge with a large force to cut off further retreat. Here, about 50 soldiers gathered around Custer, shot their horses for precedence, and fought to the end. The battle lasted 2 hours at most. 5 miles away, the rest of Custer's regiment remained under siege. On the morning of June 27th, after the Sioux and Cheyenne had departed, General Terry's column arrived and hastily buried the soldiers where they had fallen.
Crazy Horse came up this stream right behind. Just outside. find some horses. Pantry, the bunk, and the seats. Sitting on the pad, concrete pad. I don't see a water hookup though, or sewerage. Old pines stacked up here. I don't know if they're getting ready to put up some teepees or not. Signals, baggage carts. What, I don't know. I might find this has some significance. Maybe that does too. We've been taking them of any of the ranches. They're cattle ranches. You can see an awful lot of sheep here over on the other side of the hill, both sides of the road. Dams here. Is over on the other side. I don't know if they have been separated or separated themselves. Well, right down here next to the fence when I got out. But they're following the leader.
Yeah. somewhere. I can hear the machine. Air drills running.
This isn't that cold.
Oh, yeah. Is
it high?
Face finished by the end of the decade. Wolf knew that he walked up the underside of the arm, up on the top of the arm, and now headed towards the face. Signed the priest that we have. Sure enough, this is the last picture I'll take of the mountain. I was fortunate enough to get back here at the end of the century when the head is supposed to be completed. You may be able to see people working up there. I can't see them with the naked eye, but I'll check later with the binoculars. Suspended platform. Also, one hanging in the swing scaffolding or platform working right in the area to the left of the horse's head on what will be his little up here feeding. Sparrows right at the base of it. And down the valley where we came out of. This is Keystone, South Dakota, just outside of a short distance from Mount Rushmore. A Brooklyn Historical Museum is here.
Back there,
and you can see right here. Yeah, standing right at the foot of the stage, looking up over the American flag. Looking back up towards the observation. Gift shop, whatever up there. Big program down here, lighting program, and some performances on the stage starting at 8 o'clock this evening. Lighting will be at 9:30. from this doctor's studio. Wench. Tunnels in the pines. You see the Mount Rushmore directly ahead of us. I also want to take a picture of this bridge behind us. Gideon designed and built these bridges out of the native lumber. It was cut to fit, treated, and assembled. This is a river makes a 360-degree turn. You go under the bridge, then over the bridge, two tunnels. Rushmore looking through the two tunnels, standing on top of the bridge. All forget in these bridges, in these tunnels. Margaret patiently waiting. Hey, back up. I can't get your picture here. Sharp turn up there and this whole herd of wild burros feeding right along the road. I stopped it. Get a picture, rolled the window down. Darn if one of them didn't come up and stick his head in the window. Couldn't get much of a picture. Herd of buffalo over here. Long. Here we have another one. Good sized herd of buffalo. We saw part of them. Down below, on the far side of the hill. They got a watering hole down there. They look like there might be 50 or 60 of them. Four. Another one, nurse. A whole herd here, and it looks like they're all cows and they're young. They picked the ticks and the bugs off of them. That to get a free ride. Mama. And the little baby back here is two of them.
Brian's right. foot.
Here's Devil's Tower in Crook County, Wyoming, about 20 miles from Sundance. Sundance Kid took his name from Sundance when he was serving time for stealing horses. General Crook gave him credit for breaking the Indians' back, so to speak, and opening up the West without fear of the Indians. However, as I remember General Crook, he may have done all that, but I've got to verify it. I think he was the kind of a person that got the job done no matter how he had to do it, which meant killing women and children. Power, the first national monument. Don't see any climbers on this side. Do you see an ambulance sitting at the base of it? See the long rib-like sections. It said the last large slab fell about 10,000 years ago, which will give you an idea how long it probably will stand. The vegetation around takes on a beauty of the Devil's Tower within my back. I'm looking out over the valley. One up there. We've been alerted. Rescue team will be coming this way. No word. They're starting, well, somebody's starting down from that point too now, aren't they? With the injured person on a one-wheeled litter. They're starting to take a picture of them coming down, but they said no pictures.
There were a whole bunch of people, a whole bunch of climbers involved in getting them down then. So how long did it take them to get to them after it fell?
Thank you.
Somebody's got a broken back, is that not right then? They don't know.
I can't get them. They back ordered them. But they should just do that one.
Yeah.
They're going up, they're almost achieved their goal. Coming down, they've got a long way to come. Climbers all over this mountain. I don't know how many are part. In front of the prairie dog town of Devil's Tower as we are leaving. Oh, Devil's Tower, now we see the devil. Here for the celebration, but we'll be thinking about you. Stuff you could have. Since we aren't allowed to take pictures during the performance. Told her we could go in and take some pictures. Now, so we're on our way to. Eat. And I thought, we have excellent seats. Set in the Black Hills. Wall, South Dakota. Cold water spring. Well, that man and woman that built the town found the spring. In the Badlands, about 15 minutes out of a wall.
bare shale, the gully below. That's what we're looking at.
The storm is moving into this area. We're looking down at the road we came up. There's a vehicle going. Beautiful. The sun is setting over the top of the hill behind me. So bright you can't look at it. The storm, I think, is off in the distance. With all the threats of tornado warnings and for wall in this area. The Badlands. The main thing that we got was it probably won't turn out very well. I can't even look at it. I don't know how the camera will. Wind's still blowing. It appears. I know that tornado warning was turned to a tornado watch about an hour ago. So I hope it is all behind us. This is a right nice campground. This is the most spectacular view yet. Thank you. just a prairie dog. I guess they know. It's in bloom and it's growing all over the roof of this side house. It comes back down the back side of the house over the cave. I guess it was the place to store food. I'm sure that's the back house. First one.
homesteads were filed for in Jackson County at the turn of the century. The largest number of homesteads filed for in any one year.
Chicken run right here.
Showcase the latest in farming equipment and celebrate a new land and a new West. To fully appreciate the magnitude of this effort, it must be remembered that farming in those days was a hands-on business, and the hundreds of bushels of corn.
Badlands. The nice, lush vegetation. These campgrounds. About 3 miles. About 3 miles east of Mitchell. I guess Maureen is going up to Mark is going up to call Maureen. Tell her where we are and when to expect us. This is the Fred Little campground. Camp Hostess coming by. Poster. I think she came out to put the flag up. I think she might be out of bed early. It's 10 o'clock, and I don't think she usually gets up to about 1. This is the house that's built into the side of the hill. always hear stories about the guy that lives there. Apparently the woman is very nice. Son Maureen, his newest acquisition, which is in itself a story. Separate story that
I'm always taking a picture of Don taking a picture
told it at the entrance to the trailer. Where's Gene?
Yeah, I'm here. Look.